Realty.
Smart. To be honest, I'm the first to admit that at Cheltenham, if anything, he looked if he wanted another half a mile. I've only spoken to Pat Pugh briefly about it, really, and we'll be talking and seeing how he is. Let Nick have a sit on him next week.
He's looking really good. He's looking bad.
I'd quite like to go to Aintree, I must admit.
I mean, my read of the champion chase was he showed about that much of his class, some of his class, and all of his guts.
Yes, he showed us another thing, that he's actually, he knows how to fight as well, and he's very, very good at that.
So he's in good shape, you're happy with him, 2.5 miles at Aintree is possibly on the agenda, but I'll
wait for the celebration chase, which he's won the last 2 years.
That'll be fun, taking on Surname.
Well, no, don't take on Surname. Good, Aintree instead.
Who's top?
The horse behind him is Beware the Bear. Now, that was a tough performance to win the Ultimate.
Yes.
Well, that was a great. Jerry gave him a great ride because we decided that we were going to ride him completely different. We've always sort of had him up the front, but then he always drops himself out the back.
Nicky raced about 5 miles away from Newbury. So he. They need a gallop. On grass. He takes them. There.
I have to say, I now rather regret that we didn't put him in the Grand National because we didn't think it would suit him. But he proved that he can cope with big fields, and that was a great performance.
The horse behind him is William Henry. I would suggest to you that might have been your best festival training performance.
It was great for Di, who loves it, and we've had some great days together. But incredible ride from him. I mean, he was way out the back, so was the runner-up, Ruby and Nico, the two top weights. And they came literally from the back of the corral, and you think that's the last place you'd watch the
sound judgment of pace?
Recording.
Exactly. They got their.
They'll put it in the Facebook group later.
First and second top weights in the race, and they came from first.
Yeah, looking fab. You wouldn't believe the bad.
Great riding, great performance.
And you were mentioning Pentland Hills. I came down to Seven Barrows earlier in the week and interviewed a couple of the owners of Pentland Hills, a couple of the 3,000 owners of Pentland Hills. That is a seriously well-run operation, and it's great to see so many people getting franchised by this sport.
Well, it is, and I mean, you know, it's an offshoot of Elite, and I mean, they do a wonderful job, and it's amazing, wherever I've been in the last week, there are Pentland Hills everywhere, and all say, you know,
all right, mate. Don't get so excited. Watch the post.
Say about this trainers' championship or not?
I don't think so.
No, I'm not raising the white flag.
Right. Just
looking fab, isn't it? Little road coming out.
I think I hand over this time. Okay, well, you'll enjoy all these good horses. Keep winning.
It's nicer when they do that because they let the masses see them.
I think it's from Nicky Henderson there, and his tribute to North Beale as well. Of course, they.